Musically, my favorite episodes are Happy Patterners Island and The Night of Grog.
The Grog is a mysterious, silent gray shadow. Perhaps she just reflects our own fears.
Both of these episodes are very, very good in every sense. I love the stories. I love the kind of like the fantasy and the big mystery in both of them. Mystery of these weird and even scary and kind of like misjudged creatures in both cases.
The monster fish episode, where Moomin Papa is going on about the mameluk, the fish. The music that usually accompanies mameluk is one of these things that I would have not written in my spare time. I would have not felt the motivation for it, but to have it happen like this was a great roller coaster. You're sitting down writing something that makes you sort of laugh and blush already while you're writing it. It's great.
But then on the other hand, The Invisible Child is such a beautiful and important story.
There. Hope it's not too tight or too loose. It's hard to tell. Come on.
They're all great, but Ninny sort of became my favorite thing to write. The way the music reacts to the story is really interesting. And for example, in Ninny's case, certain musical things, certain gestures feel and sound completely different because it's about her than they would do if it would be like a separate track on an instrumental album of whatever music. Or in any of the other episodes. We could have used some similar music, for example, with Miss Abel, with Moomin Mama's Maid, but it would have resonated completely differently and I think quite wrong. But with Ninny, it was like the story provides the exact right lighting for the music, if that makes any sense.
At least we know she wants to be seen now.
Would you like some breakfast, dear?
Look, her paws!
It's all very well showing your extremities, but you must look an awful fright if you keep your face hidden.
Oh, that was your fault.
Ha! She's too timid.
Through Ninny, also the music for Too-Ticky that happens in the last episode, those were kind of the things that I thought I'm going to be very happy for a very long time that they got done.
And finally, yeah, one of my favorite episodes is the last one, Midwinter Ancestor, which is very tragic because Moomin Troll almost dies in the story and the cute character Ancestor saves him, and they have such a beautiful bonding at the end of the episode, and we have Too-Ticky and she's so cool.
Cold paws? I know just the thing.
Ninny?
Ninny is staying with my sister. These are invisible shrews. Hold out your paws.
Hang on, but if they're invisible, how do you know they're shrews?
All things are so very uncertain. And that's exactly what makes me feel reassured.
There was something sort of extra cool, extra touching about her attitude in that scene. How all the uncertain things are the ones that make her really happy. And I think during the time when we were scoring the last episode with this very scene, there were so many things around that were uncertain. And it was sort of possibly a little bit difficult to feel completely joyous about the our own uncertainties. So she came in kind of like as a breath of fresh air, and something just clicked. And of course, there was this idea that I knew that Too-Ticky is going to happen a lot more in the future of the series, that she's going to have more time in the second season. And I wanted to have something for her that will be like a really good, beautiful chunk of wood to carve from, even in the future of the episode. So a melody that doesn't exhaust itself in one episode.